With me now is Todd Barber, who's a Hollison resident, decided he wanted to do something for his community, and we're going to talk about it a little bit. Hey, Todd, how are you?
Great, great. Nice to meet you, Ray.
Nice to meet you, too. Thanks for coming down. You are heading up a huge project in Holliston through Habitat for Humanity. First of all, let's just start with that. Explain to everybody. I'm sure everybody by now knows what Habitat for Humanity is, but let's talk about that a little bit.
Yeah, Habitat for Humanity is an organization that works to provide housing for people in need. It's all about providing a hand up and not a hand out. So the requirements for people to participate in getting a Habitat house are all about being able to satisfy some minimum income requirements. They will be paying a mortgage, although it would be subsidized. They also have to put about 400 to 500 hours of sweat equity of their own into Habitat. Either working in the offices or even pounding nails on their own house to help create the value around their ownership in this project. So it's a really great way for people to participate in creating a new life for themselves with a home that they can own.
I didn't know a lot of that. I just assumed that you built a house and you just give it to somebody.
Well, in some respects, it is like that, but it is not quite so simple. So it is about having a minimum set of income requirements, usually 40 to 60% of the median income of a particular community.
That's certainly helpful.
It does. But the mortgage does get subsidized by Habitat. The mortgage is held by Habitat. It's not about somebody coming in and getting a house and being able to flip it. Habitat retains ownership rights in that house for a period of time, and in this case, in Holliston, it's a collaboration with the town of Holliston. There was some surplus land in Holliston, and Holliston wanted to do something interesting and important with that piece of land, and they did an RFP, and Habitat actually answered the RFP and was granted use of the land to create two houses for families that could be in Holliston. One would be a local preference, so hopefully someone in Holliston that's not currently owning that wanted to stay in Holliston, and the other house open for a broader lottery, people that maybe want to move into Holliston.
And who doesn't? Who doesn't want to move into Holliston?
Well, it is a great town.
It really is.
It is a great town.
So you had the land. Did Habitat come to you, or did you go to Habitat?
Interestingly, over the years, I've always thought, if I want to give back, what would I want to do? And I always said, I'd love to do something like Habitat.
Yeah.
I'd love to do a Habitat project. And then I thought, well, why not Habitat? And I had a former coworker, a friend of mine, who was named the executive director of the Habitat chapter in North Central Massachusetts. And I asked Carolyn Reed, how do I get involved in Habitat? She said, well, I can't really use you way up here because you're way down in Metro West area. But my neighbor is Tim Ferment, who's the executive director of the Metro West and Greater Worcester chapter of Habitat. Let me introduce you to Tim. So in January, Tim and I sat down. We spent a little time together. And Tim said, well, I've got a bunch of things going on, but one project is a project to build two homes in Holliston. And I have two kids in Holliston schools. This year, they're seniors, twins, boy-girl twins. And I thought, well, that's the project that I should line up with.
Sure.
And so we kind of kicked off earlier this year, and we've been working to raise awareness and, more importantly, raise money so that we can justify putting shovel in the dirt, breaking ground, and getting this project off the ground.
When you're raising money for a house that Habitat's going to build, what are you raising that money for exactly?
Well, it's to build these homes. So it's everything from clearing the land to putting in the foundations to procuring all the materials and the labor. So a lot of the donations to Habitat are actually called gifts in kind. So it's not always cash, although cash helps fill in the blanks of the things that haven't been donated. Mm-hmm. But gifts in kind are where craftspeople may donate a well or do a well at half price. They may do the foundation or give the concrete at a deep discount. Someone may do kitchen cabinets at cost and maybe do the installation for free. So those gifts come in many different forms, but all contribute to building up the gift, if you will, or the contributions that we're raising that cover the cost of building these two homes.
It's a great chance for the entire community to get involved, not just individual volunteers, but companies and businesses as well. And for you, it must warm the heart. It must be cool waking up and being involved in this.
It is pretty cool. And when people get what Habitat is all about and what the goal is to build these homes for people that need housing and that want to be in a community, there's a great groundswell of support for it. So it's really gratifying to be a part of and to see the support that people put behind it.
All right, so you were looking for something to do for your community. You got Habitat involved. You started raising the money. What's the next step?
Yeah, so our total budget for building two homes is slightly over $400,000. So the goal was to at least get $200,000 of that put together before we actually break ground. As of this morning, we're in the neighborhood of about $150,000. So the Holliston Housing Trust, which was the arm of the Holliston town government that really brokered the transition of the land to Habitat, graciously donated $100,000 towards that.
Wow.
We've got in the neighborhood of $20,000 to $25,000 worth of gifts in kind already, including land clearing, including some discounted tree cutting, including some cabinet making, including some discounted lumber and other topics. And then we have cash donations close to $20,000 already. And we've had a number of fundraisers that have driven that. We set up a crowdfunding site for fundraising. There's a website called youcaring.com.
Okay.
So if you go to the youcaring.com website and type in Holliston in the search bar, the Habitat Project for Holliston will pop up. We've raised some donations there, but we've raised some others just through corporate donations, through people, individuals writing checks towards Habitat. We did a fundraiser at Celebrate Holliston, which is the local town festival in Holliston in September, and we built a playhouse. So one of the fundraisers that Habitat does is build a playhouse project. And in this case, Habitat collaborates with a veterans group to identify a veteran family in need. We had a bunch of volunteers actually create, build, paint, and customize a playhouse for this family.
Hmm.
And at the end of the day, that family actually showed up at Celebrate Holliston. We did a dedication ceremony to that family, and they took that playhouse away to put in their backyard and and be a part of their family going forward. But we get corporations that will sometimes sponsor a build a playhouse event where they can draw attention to the fact that they're giving back to the community. They can get their employees involved with a project for team building and get some excitement going around awareness for Habitat, and in the same time giving some donation to Habitat that helps us build these two families' homes in Holliston.
Todd Barber is with me from Holliston, and he is heading up two projects with Habitat for Humanity in Holliston. What was the Sign a Stud benefit that you did?
Yeah, so we also did a Sign a Stud at Celebrate Holliston, and we've done it at the Holliston Senior Auction, and you'll be seeing it at other places as we find places to sponsor that. But Sign a Stud is a really cool idea where you take a stud that will eventually go into the homes that we're building, one of the two homes, and people get to sign on that stud. And for any contribution, we suggest a dollar. Many people give $5, $10, or $20 or more.
Mm.
And what we'll do is once that stud is actually placed in the home and before the walls are sealed up, we'll have an open house and invite anybody who was a part of signing a stud to come and actually see that their name is on a stud that's being built into the home in Holliston. So it's a little bit of ownership and community awareness to build that pride around what we're doing on a bigger level.
How do you find the families?
So Habitat has a pretty rigorous process for they will publicly post that they're actually taking applications for these homes. They try and flight it, of course, closer to when they think the homes will be built. But they go through an application process, they go through an interview process, and they have to satisfy certain financial requirements to be able to afford this, while subsidized, a real mortgage that they have to pay. They also go through classroom training where Habitat teaches them. In most cases, these families have never owned a home before. Mm-hmm. So they're taking them through education about what does paying your mortgage look like? What does paying your taxes look like? What does home maintenance look like? What do you do if you get a leak in your roof? Who do you call and how do you do that? Habitat really partners with these families to make sure they're not just given the home and then not being set up to succeed. So,
well, it's funny because we hear so many stories. What was that show, the Extreme Makeover show? Remember? You'd hear so many stories about families just given this house or this update, and then it would just, they couldn't keep up with it.
Exactly.
It was such a beautiful house. They didn't know how to care for it, and they couldn't keep up with the mortgage. But Habitat is actually training people and helping them succeed.
Yeah, and I think the key, both from the community awareness and the community involvement with the events that we do, the fundraisers that we do, the Sign a Stud event, you want to have the community involved with helping make sure that they're around to support this family.
Mm-hmm.
Habitat is invested in making sure the family succeeds. It's really about making a win-win situation where a family in need gets that opportunity to have a step up, to have that support, and to be successful in owning a home.
Do you have a timeline? Do you have a deadline for when the hammer hits the nail?
Well, we were warned when we started that these take a little longer than we would like. And
sure.
It's not Extreme Home Makeover. It's not done in 5 days.
Yeah.
And part of it is that fundraising and community awareness part. We had hoped that we were going to break ground this fall. We still may, given we're 150,000 or so of the way to our 200,000 sort of starting point. Realistically, we're probably looking at the spring for the true groundbreaking and beginning of construction. And while, again, this isn't Extreme Home Makeover, a lot of the actual work that's done is done by volunteers and volunteer organizations. So it may take 6 months. It may take as much as a year to actually finish the home. So I think we'll have a better idea once we get shovel in the dirt. But generally, I would love to think that by next year, this time, we may be in a position to have the families moving into these two homes in Holliston.
Great. Are you a handy guy yourself?
I am a little bit, yeah. I'm not sure that, I'm a contractor grade, but yeah, I love doing projects around the house as well.
So where do you find the volunteers, and then where do you find the experts to help the volunteers along so that the house does stay, stay erect?
Sure. First of all, Habitat has their own contract manager, a construction manager, if you will, on staff. But you really can't do this without skilled professionals that are volunteers as well. So actually a lot of the gifts in kind that we get are from local crafts guys. They're the contractors, they're the plumbers, electricians, and roofers that are actually in the area that want to be a part of this program. And what also doesn't happen in a Habitat project is no project is successful without volunteer labor. So while there are some open community days where people can come from the community at Hawk and just show up and participate in the project, part of the fundraising is actually allowing companies to sponsor build days where the company can pay and then carve out days where they can send their employees to actually work on the house. So the professional construction manager and the volunteers that are contractors that are licensed help guide the volunteer labor force to the project of the day, whether it's putting in flooring, putting in a wall, hanging electrical fixtures, or what have you. So it is kind of it's a logistical, interesting challenge to manage, but getting a lot of people to participate is part of that, community investment in the program.
And anyone can participate on any level.
That's right.
Nice.
And once this project gets going, there'll be a spot on the Habitat for Humanity Metro West Greater Worcester website where volunteers can actually sign themselves up to help out that way.
All right. How can people get in touch with you? Are there any other venues people can go through to learn more about this?
Well, my personal email that I'm using is Todd Barber, TODDBARBER, at comcast.net.
Okay.
But certainly the youcaring.com, youcaring, youcaring.com, and type in Holliston. You can make a donation there. Or if you go to the Habitat for Humanity Greater Metro West and Greater Worcester webpage, you'd have to Google that, but you can get in contact with folks in the Worcester office that run the local chapter there.
Well, thank you very much for coming in, Todd. It sounds like an amazing project that just benefits our local community.
Well, Ray, thank you very much for the opportunity to come in and talk to you and highlight the project.
Yeah, so let's keep in touch and inform me on anything that's happening with the project, please.
Fantastic.
All right,
great.
Thanks.
Thank you.